Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're gonna work on this engagement ring, have this kind of wavy design on the side with the B setting. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start it with the center stone. It's an oval, it's around 6x8. And I have a video in the description below if you wanna know how to do the prong set in 3D model. But we're gonna starting with this setting in the middle for our reference. So I'm just going to hide it. And then we are going to set it a ring size. The diameter for the ring is about 16 millimeter. At first, we need to edit this circle. There's not much of an edit point right here, and then they're also creating this kink right there. So what we wanted to do is we need to rebuild this curve. Let's rebuild it into the point count for 8, degree for 3, and this is what we get. Once we rebuild it, we are going to pick up this point and this point. They are going to move it to the right, let's say 3 millimeter. And then the one right in the middle there, I'm going to move it back 0.3 millimeter. So I get something like this. Okay, let's go ahead to creating the profile. I'm going to create in the profile right here, snapping into the quadrant. And the height is about 1.5 millimeter. So I'm going to have 1.7 millimeter and want to give it a little bit round corner there. Okay, so this is what we have. Let's move it back to the center by align to horizontal center. And we also want to make a copy to the other side. All right, so now we have everything ready. We need to create two more profiles there, right? One in the middle, the other one at that 45 degree. So let's go ahead to use the rotate tool. That's snapping over here and type it 45, and also another one type it 90. So we will have two additional cross section there. With this one, let's go ahead to move it close to where that rail is going to be. The same one in the middle, I'm going to move it to close to where the rail is going to be. Let me hide this one so it's easier for you to see. The reason we want to have that 45 there is because one side is going to be higher than the other side. So what I'm going to do is using the 1D scale. I'm going to scale this up just a little bit. Doesn't have to be too tall. We just need to have a little bit more definition there. Okay, so let's go ahead to use the sweep one rail. This is our rail. And the rest of it is a cross section. Make sure everybody's aligned. I usually like them to align in the inside of the ring shank, so that way I can avoid to have a seam on my design. And make sure they are facing the same direction. Also close the sweep. So now we have something look like this. This side look a little bit fatter. We want to do a test. Let's go ahead to rotate that piece and make sure that copy equal yes. So then you will get this one. As you can see, let's take a look on the render view, like one side is higher than the other side, and then they meet right in the middle over there. So I'm not happy with the button look like a butt looking things, but we can fix that later on. Let's turn on the stone and see how's everything work. All right, so now everything's working fine. We just need to put the stone there and redo the button. So I'm going to do is to draw a straight line and using the straight line to trim the surface right there. Okay, so now I have something like this. I'm going to pick up my curve on that profile, and then we want to make a copy by using the rotate copy equal yes. Let's make one to the bottom. So now we have something like this. We're going to use the surface tool, sweep one. We're gonna go from rail, cross section, and the last cross section, and make sure they all align to the middle. And then we can create this shank. Let's take a look on the render view. So it coming into one shank instead of two. Okay, so now let's go ahead to do the stone. To do the stone, we need to know where the stone is going to be. So I'm going to use duplicate edges, and we're gonna duplicate this edges right there. Let's move it to the other layer so it's easier for us to work on it. So this is the curve that we have. We don't need the whole section there. I'm going to split that curve to the point where I think the stone should stop. And then so we can delete the other half. Okay, so this is the curve that we have. I need to know how long is that. So we're gonna use the command called length. It's 13.128. So on the top view, I'm gonna come over here to draw a line. 13.128. So this means if this curve is stretched like flat on the flat surface, this is how long it's going to be. So I bring the stone that I made before. If you want to know how to make this stone, I will include in the video in the description. So let's take a look on the top view. I want to make the two stones next to each other, and then I'm going to draw a straight line at the front view, approximately something like this in the middle. Okay, so this is going to indicate where the prong is going to be. We are going to pipe this one. Make sure your prong is big enough to cover both of the stone. I will say you will cover about 20%. So now we have something like this. Let's just go ahead to mirror to the other side. So then we'll have the prong on both sides. I'm going to delete this one. Let's go ahead to use the linear array, and we are going to go about 10, because I don't know how many do I need it. And we're gonna go something like this. You wanna make sure that it's equal size on the prong, both sides of the prong, and then you got something like this. Apparently I have more than what I need, so I'm going to delete one of them here. Okay, I also need the prong on the other side, so I'm just gonna move it over here and have something like this. Okay, so this is the arrangement that I have, and we are going to have this one flow back to this one. So I'm going to pick up everybody beside that curve, and we are going to use the command under the transform. You have flow along curve, and the base curve will be the curve over here. The target curve will be the curve over here. All right, so then this is what we have. Let's turn on the ring to see if that fit, right? So it fit it nicely. Once we have done that, you can still adjust it if you need it. And then we can come over here, just pick up everybody again. And let's go ahead to rotate our stone and make sure copy equal yes, center to the zero, and let's move it to the other side. So double check the stone flow nicely. This edge of the stone is not hanging out. The prong is touching both sides of the stone. All we need to do now is trim the extra. Once everything is trimmed, and also trim the one in the center. If you'd like to know more about stone setting, I have a stone setting course online. I will put the description below. Check it out and let me know if you have any question. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.